Welcome to Analytics with Nux. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the Gantt chart in the Visuals with Nux series. And if you are not aware of Gantt chart, it's used to track any KPI measures, key measures against your goal, right? So that is what the Gantt chart is all about. And before getting into what are other reasons you can see, if you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button. As the YouTube chat says, 60% of this channel is not yet subscribed. That will definitely motivate us to do more. With this note, let's begin. So when to use, as I said, it's used to show the progress towards the goal, represent a percentile measure like a KPI. So you have a KPI, you want to show it in percentile value. Show the health of single measure. So as soon as you see this Gantt chart, you can see whether it's good or bad or poor, right? So display information, you can quickly scan and understand. So as soon as you see it, it indicates the you can achieve the goal or it's progressing quick. So that is what a Gantt chart within as soon as you see it, you will understand what is the status of that KPI. With this note, let us try to jump into a demo. Now I am in Power BI. As we are aware of about this Naga Garments sales data, we have a sales date and we have a location, three locations and different category name. I have a target sales. So this is improperly built model. If most of the people are doing like this, if they have data like this, they need to do like this, okay? And then I will try to explain how you properly build your target sales in a proper modeling. That will be really quick. I will show it. And now with improper modeling, like you have this data where you will have a different sales for each product in each day, right? Each day you have different products sold in different locations. This is the granularity of the data. Now the user sets the target at the monthly level, okay, the month level target. But what happens for each row, he has put 200,000. So but it is not actually the day wise target, but he has, you don't know where to have this target data. Then what happened is like he put it in the same table with monthly level target for each location. So this is monthly level target for a location. So that is what the user set here. So you need to, in this case, the report should be built at the monthly level. At least the filters should appear for the monthly level. Otherwise, the data won't be meaningful, the target data. So now let's try to use the Gantt chart. Now we have Gantt chart. Now you can see here, in order to show this value, you need to drag and drop what value you want to track the progress, then the target value. Here in this case, it's going to be sales amount or item amount. Item amount is your the value you want to track, and the target sales. The target sales, it is a target value, okay? And the important thing to note here is by default it will be sum. As I said before, for each row it will have a data. If you want to see the, it will be summed up. The total value is your target now. So assume you have 1000 rows, 1000 into 200,000. So that should not be the case. So you need to set to maximum. This is your first step when you have data like this. Once you set this, now you can see here the target becomes here. But this sales is not for the monthly. So what you need to do, you need to make it properly, like you need to have a filters over here, right? Let's put the filters here using the sales date hierarchy. Let me increase the size a little bit so that you can see it properly. Okay, now in this I want to track, right, on February. And as I said before, this is for the each location wise sales. So I will try to filter the data for a location. I will have a visual level filter here, version 9. Now this is the one. So like this, you need to filter the data if you improperly design your data, right? I mean to say, like, you need to set the maximum instead of the aggregation, default aggregation. So when you touch this visual, you are setting the target as maximum because there is no granularity you define. So you need to set the maximum here. And this is what, and always you need to filter any particular month to track the status. And this is for the location, right? So each location you have the data here. Even you can mention based on if for different location you can mention different values. How you can easily do it, I will show it to you. So first I will complete this get start part. Now you can see here this tracking the process, like now it's almost 20th of June or 25th of June. So in 25th of June, I'm sorry, so now it's in February, right? Now you are seeing in February, assume we are in February 2020, and at almost you are at the 25th of February. So you are not going to anyway achieve this target because almost halfway through, it is from 200k target, you achieved only 60%, not even 60, so 55 or 58% here. So anyway, in another 5 days, you're going to not going to reach. So in this case, you have can able to step in, like you can give offers or some discounts so that it will not have any loss for you, but you need to set a target goal you can reach. So in a glance, you can able to decide what you should do now, right? So in this way, you can arrange it. Now, how you can view for different location sales, just copy and paste here. Okay, now instead of this you choose Bangalore, this is fine, and take this guy and put it again, choose Hyderabad. Let's see what happened here. Target sales, maximum target sales, I hope the data is very less here. Let's try to check for another month. Okay, I hope the data is not properly built for those months. So basically, when you see here, this is for September 2019. So you are setting the target for different locations. It will be in the same table. Then you can able to view it here, how much you have achieved during that month. So when you filter by the months. So this is what. But now you want to set the target for each location differently. How you can do? Now for that I have a model here, I mean I have simple data over here, the table which contains a target table. Okay, I need to rename it. So location and target, in this table I have Chennai, this is the target, this can be a monthly target, you can able to change it. Now go to this tab and instead of using this particular target, right, target sales from the same table, you can use this target, right? So let us try to copy these three. Okay, now I'll put it over here, right? Then instead of this target, okay, and location is should not be a filter from data table, I'm removing the location filter from the data table. Instead I need to use a table that I've used here, so put it over here, then use Bangalore, then here it's Chennai, I think Chennai. So here use the location Chennai. Okay, and this target should be replaced by this target. Okay, again you can put some over here, I didn't properly designed it. Now this location should be used by here and it is Bangalore. Again you replace this one, you can put this target here some. Okay, then again you can use this one, location here Hyderabad. Then the target should be not from the data table, should be from the target table. I put some over here. Now you can see you can set the different targets over here. Here, when you have a single table, obviously, like in a data table itself, if you have different targets over here, instead of having for each location, if you set the target and doing max will give you different target. But for each location, you need to set different targets here. You can define it in a table and it is very easy to customize, right? Now you have like for Chennai, it's 190K and for Bangalore is 180K and for Hyderabad 200K. So now you can easily track and easily customizable. So here you can say 190K, 180K, 200K is your target. So this way you can able to do the more customization of your get shot. This is the one of the thing, the properly building the model. And another example, you will ask me like, how about setting the targets at month level? Say for example, on Chennai March 2020, I need this. On Chennai April 2020, I need different targets. So each month wise, I need to define the targets. Then how I should design. So I'm not going to do that right now. Instead, I will show you how you need to design your model over here. Just use some diagram here. So use like this is your sales table. Like here you have a sales fact. Okay. Let's name it a sales fact. Then you have a location dimension, okay? Location dimension. Then you design your date dimension. Right now we have seen that you do not have any date dimension. So design like this. Again, you need to have one target table, right? Target set table, target fact, you can say target fact. Okay, in this table you should have location and month. Instead of date you should have a month, then the target. So as we seen in our current example, we have a location and target. If you want to define the targets at the month level, right, you need to define both, right? So now how you need to relate, you need to link it like this in your model, then again link it. So in this way, if you design it, you can define the targets for each location or any other category of values, and then you can relate. This is how you need to properly design. We will discuss more about the designing principles, but this is about the get shot. Let's look at some of the properties you can set finally. Like you have a gauge axis, it's not so important, and you can use this data colors to fill it. So obviously when it's progress, it's better to put it in some green kind of stuffs. So in that way you can able to track it. Then target can be a red. So this has the important property, and this value is nothing but the callout value. You can enable or disable it, right? So this is, you can do it. Then these are the labels, the minimum and maximum. So data labels, you can disable it most of the time. When you have some maximum value for you to define, then in that case, use this one. Otherwise, you can remove it. Then other things are common properties, shadow, backgrounds, all other things are common to all other visuals. I hope you liked it. Hit the thumbs up button and press the bell icon if you need a notification. And do remember that data is your asset.